You're not thin. You scare people, and I'm guessing you like that. But the way that you're going, one day you won't wake up. And I'm not going to treat you if you aren't interested in living.
Good speech.
If I'm going to help you.
Well, Netflix got a lot of feedback, both positive and negative, about their series 13 Reasons Why, which dealt with teen suicide. Now a Netflix movie is getting similar attention. It is called To the Bone. It focuses on struggles with eating disorders, specifically anorexia. But is it triggering or inspiring? Author Lee Wolfe Blum is a mental health practitioner at Melrose Center, an eating disorder survivor as well, and she has recently wrote the book about this, or wrote a book about it, but also wrote an article for the Star Tribune on this topic. Thank you for coming in.
Thank you for having me.
I had a chance to watch this yesterday, and it's a really compelling movie about this young girl, and I had certain thoughts about it. I thought, well, this is probably good for most people, but then you brought up some really good points about why it's possibly not very good for any young person to watch this movie.
Right. You know, we have this idea that eating disorders are only about anorexia. And the reality is there's five other eating disorders in the DSM-5 that are clinical eating disorders. So this movie focuses on one that tends to be glamorized, which is anorexia, when the reality is 30 million people in the United States are struggling with an eating disorder. One third of them are men. So the movie only captures a small sliver of this. And the issue I have with it is when you look at the research, a recent study was done, 14 to 15 year olds, the biggest predictor for them to develop an eating disorder is a diet. So if a young kid turns on this movie just thinking they're just gonna watch it, and then watches it and says, oh, maybe I should lose some weight, this thinness looks cool, that is usually the predetermining factor for somebody to develop an eating disorder. Mm-hmm. Not everyone who goes on a diet develops an eating disorder, but a diet is the biggest predictor to an eating disorder.
And a lot of them have a genetic disposition as well that they might not know about. So if they have alcoholism in their family or any kind of addiction in their family, this could lead to it as well.
Right, so when I describe about my own experience, there's me and there's my sister, we grew up in the exact same household. Why did I develop an eating disorder and she didn't? And what we like to say in the field is there's biological, psychological, and social. So a movie like To the Bone on Netflix is not gonna cause an eating disorder. But if you've got the biological, the psychological, let's say that there's depression and anxiety going on, that trigger gets pulled when somebody goes on a diet, and it lights up the brain, similar to an addiction. So for me, it was very
euphoric.
Yes, very euphoric. So I think it's really important that we're having this discussion. I think it's important that we're talking about it because eating disorders and other mental illnesses are very taboo to talk about, and people feel a lot of shame. And I think it's really important. It's great that Netflix did this because now we're having the conversation. Mm-hmm. And I caution especially young people and parents to really be a critical viewer when you're watching a show like this.
Yep, and a couple of things to note. First of all, the treatment that goes on in this show, you said, is absolutely nothing like the real treatment.
Right.
I mean, the fact that they're alone in this house and they eat alone and things like that.
Right.
So just note that as well. And then I also think that the other thing to note is that these days, versus when we grew up, these kids are looking at themselves every second on Snapchat, and they're looking at each other too. So it has become such ethnocentric society where people are looking. So maybe it would even be more of an issue because they're looking at themselves constantly and they're comparing themselves to all their other peers.
Right, and you don't want somebody looking at this and saying, oh, maybe I could be as thin as this girl, you know? And then our society looks at something like this and says, oh, I can tell who has an eating disorder because I've seen this show. And like I mentioned before, you know, you can't tell who has an eating disorder by looking at them. You sometimes can tell with anorexia, but the other clinical eating disorders, you can't. Mm-hmm. The other piece that people don't realize about a show like this is when somebody with an eating disorder watches a show like this, it becomes fuel for the fire. So when they're in the throes of an eating disorder, a patient would watch this and say, I'm not sick enough.
I'm not sick enough.
I need to be as sick as this girl.
And that's what happens in this show. She doesn't think she's sick enough, but she
And I can promise you, almost every patient I've ever met with has always said those words to me, I'm not sick enough. And so I don't want people, especially in the throes of an eating disorder, to watch this and let it fuel the fire.
Right. Well, Lee, we really appreciate your insight on this. And your book, which is Table in the Darkness, is all about this as well.
Yes.
And that's available, and we'll let people know how to also get a hold of the Melrose Center. We have that link on care11.com. Mm-hmm. We're going to head to the kitchen next.